This is a bunch of copper metal that I've had sitting around, and I want to try turning it into gold. To get started, I just have to drop a crucible into a small furnace. Then I can turn it on and close the lid, and wait for it to heat up. After several minutes, it's gotten pretty hot, and it should be around 1200 C, or 2200 Fahrenheit. Now, I can start adding my pieces of copper. As they sat there, they eventually became red hot, but it wasn't quite hot enough to melt them. In theory, I could have just shut the lid and waited, but I wanted to actually see them liquefy. So, I instead blasted them with a blowtorch, and this honestly worked a lot better than I expected. However, the liquid copper then started bubbling and spitting out molten metal, which wasn't super safe. So I shut the lid, and a few minutes later, it was looking a lot better. At this point though, it's still all just copper, and the magic only happens when I add some extra ingredients. The first is some aluminum, and it all quickly melts. I'll then scoop off some slag from the surface, and the next thing to add is some zinc metal. I'll then mix it around a bit to make sure all the zinc has dissolved. Now it's time to add the last ingredient, which is just a small amount of tin metal. This isn't nearly as reactive as the zinc, and I'll close the lid and let it cook for a bit. After a couple minutes, it should be good to go, and it's time to pour it out. Right now, it's still red hot, but as it cools, a really nice golden color slowly appears. I can then pull it out of the mold and dunk it into some water. After this, I can clean it up a bit, and I now have a nice gold bar. Unfortunately though, it of course isn't actually real gold, and it just looks like it. It's called Nordic gold, and I think it's pretty cool.